Sales of baked goods in the Philippines projected to reach $2.5 billion by 2027. That's according to the U.S. Department of Agriculture. It said in 2022, the retail value of baked products was estimated at $1.9 billion. $1.5 billion was spent on ingredients, with more than 75% imported. The USDA said flour was the most significant import, accounting for 70% of the cost of baking pandesal, the staple bread in the country. Its report also said traders believe the U.S. is well-positioned to increase its export of baking ingredients to the Philippines in the coming years. Also in Pampanga, President Marcos led the signing of an agreement to establish his Kadiwa program in local government units nationwide. There, he reaffirmed his commitment to bring down the price of rice to 20 pesos per kilo. Pia Gutierrez reports.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Monday reaffirmed his administration's commitment to make quality goods and commodities accessible to Filipinos nationwide while improving the agricultural sector of the country. This as he led the nationwide launch of his Kadiwa ng Pangulo program at the Pampanga provincial capital in San Fernando City. During the program, several national government agencies signed a memorandum of agreement formalizing their partnership to support LGUs to establish Kadiwa ng Pangulo markets in their own locality. And according to the DALG, 81 provinces and 16 NCR LGUs participated in the launch. They are expected to facilitate the Kadiwa ng Pangulo centers every 15th and 30th of the month, where local farmers are expected to sell their produce to consumers at an affordable price, including rice at 25 pesos per kilo and sugar at 70 pesos per kilo. In his speech, the president noted the need to further increase production of agricultural commodities to bring food prices down in the country.
Yung ating hangarin na 20 pesos na bigas, wala pa tayo ron. Pero ginagawa natin ang lahat. Ngayon, para paramihin talaga ang kadiwa, ang kailangan natin ay paramihin ang produksyon ng lahat ng mga agricultural commodities. Magsimula na tayo sa agricultural commodities dahil yun ay pangangailangan ng taong bayan upang mabuhay ang sarili nila at ang kanilang mga pamilya.
In the same program, President Marcos Jr. also led the distribution of various government assistance to a number of individuals, farmers, groups, and local government units in Pampanga. Meanwhile, in a media interview, President Marcos Jr. said he's confident that the Philippines has made significant progress during his first year as president, and this is what he will present in his second State of the Nation address. He says he will explain in his speech that there has been a significant improvement in terms of how government works and how the Philippines is seen or judged in the international community under his administration. Marcos Jr. says his sauna will be a performance report to let the Filipino people see that his many pronouncements are not simply lip service and that he will show the progress of the promises he made last year and what else needs to be done in the country.
President Marcos leads the groundbreaking ceremony of a new medical facility in Pampanga. The Clark Multi-Specialty Medical Center will provide specialized care in four medical disciplines: pediatric, renal, cardiovascular, and oncology. In his speech, Marcos vowed to give every Filipino access to quality health care.
I will be reporting to the nation on the progress that we have made in establishing and opening new healthcare centers around the country. But that is the product of our relentless push for universal healthcare, and we will not stop until every Filipino can say they have good access to quality health care. I cannot endure the sight of seeing a fellow Filipino suffer only because of the lack of facilities in our health system. It's not a privilege to have health care. It is a right. And that is how we will approach this problem.
The chairman of the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation defends the price tag for their new logo. Alejandro Tenco says 3 million pesos is not much. He adds it covers not only the design but also other deliverables.
I don't think the critics or the fashions were aware. Hindi lang po naman 3 million yung logo lang. There are so many other deliverables. na ipagkakaloob ng designer tulad po nung mga manual. Meron po, hindi naman po yan basta kuha ng lowit tapos na ron. Meron po yung manual. Meron po yung mga application. I'll be honest with you, I'm not affected at all. I think we made a good decision and yung decision po na yun ay paninindigan natin. That's a management prerogative.
The new PagCorp logo has been heavily criticized with allegations of plagiarism and for looking similar to logos of several brands. The Energy Regulatory Commission is likely to appeal a recent court decision allowing power firms owned by San Miguel Corporation to raise rates. Energy Secretary Lotilia told ANC, while the government respects the court's decision, it was also important to look at the stability of contracts between distribution utilities and power generation firms.
That's always a problem in this particular case. If the courts are going to second guess the technical decisions of the Energy Regulatory Commission. So it is important for the courts to look into whether or not there is a technical basis for the Energy Regulatory Commission to act accordingly. And of course, it takes into account also the legal basis of the Energy Regulatory Commission. But as it is, since this is before the courts, we will allow we will respect the courts, especially if this is brought up before the Supreme Court, to lay down the appropriate rules on this.
The Court of Appeals had ruled the ERC acted with grave abuse of discretion by junking the 2022 petitions of Meralco and two of San Miguel subsidiaries for a rate hike due to higher fuel costs. Now, the Philippine Energy Department is hopeful the importation of liquefied natural gas will stabilize the country's power supply. Energy Secretary Rafael Lotilia says transitioning to LNG will help in ensuring energy security in the long run. He adds it will also help the country wean away from coal as its major fuel source. But Lotilia notes the new power source could lead to higher electricity prices for Filipinos.
LNG itself is, as you know, higher than our indigenous or Malampaya gas. So it is indeed going to have some impact on the price, especially in the light of the higher prices that we have faced since the invasion of Ukraine. But then, in the long run, the availability of supply from all over the world in terms of new natural gas supply coming on stream, especially in the years 2025 to 26. So hopefully this is going to stabilize the supply. But right now, because of the shortfall in the Malampaya gas, definitely we have to bring in imported gas to balance or to make up for the shortfall.
This comes as the output of the Malampaya gas field, which supplies 20% of Luzon's electricity requirement, is starting to dwindle. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. recently extended the Malampaya gas field contract by 15 years.
Cash remittances sent to the Philippines reached $2.49 billion in May 2023. That is 2.8% higher compared to the same period last year. The Philippine Central Bank attributes the expansion to the growth in receipts from land and sea-based workers, especially those in the United States, Singapore, Saudi Arabia, and Japan. Further rate hikes from the Philippine Central Bank not yet off the table. BSP Chief Eli Remolona said that in an interview with Bloomberg TV. He believes it is still premature to consider a rate cut, adding for now, the Monetary Board is only contemplating on whether to hike rates or keep them as they are. Remolona notes the BSP is monitoring the local currency and the U.S. Federal Reserve. Now in June, the BSP kept policy rates steady at 6.25% after months of deceleration in Philippine inflation. The BSP's next rate-setting meeting set on August 17.
Now, motorists better gas up today as a big-time oil price hike looms Tuesday. Diesel prices will see the biggest jump of 2 pesos and 10 centavos per liter. Gasoline and kerosene prices also set to go up by nearly 2 pesos per liter. Industry players say this week's increase in pump prices is due to the earlier decision of Saudi Arabia to cut oil production by 1 million barrels per day this July. Water Concessionaire Maynila temporarily lifts its daily service interruptions in some parts of Metro Manila thanks to the recent rains. Maynila says the rains brought by Tropical Storm Dodong helped raise the water level at Ipodam and Angat Dam. But Maynila also warns it could continue limiting the water supply in the region once the rains stop. Last week, Maynila implemented daily water interruptions affecting nearly 600,000 customers.